So this works for things other than words. The place where you've seen it the most so far has been in language, but we're also going to see how to use it to make procedures. And you'll also see how to use it in later classes, how to define data structures. There are lots and lots of different things in computing that are defined recursively. And a recursive definition has two parts. It has the base case. In our example with the word, that was the second rule. And the base case, we can think of it as a starting point. And the important thing about the base case is it's not defined in terms of itself. It has to be something where we already know how to define it. So for programs, it's usually going to be the smallest input or one of the simplest inputs, something where we already know the answer. We don't have to do any computation to figure it out. The second part is the recursive case, and that is defined in terms of itself. But it shouldn't be defined in terms of itself exactly. It should be defined in terms of some sort of smaller version of itself. We need to make progress to eventually get to the base case. We'll see what that means in programs soon. First, we're going to try one other example, not in terms of a program, just to get a better sense for how things can be defined recursively.